right, Diana Ross, love taught me who was the boss. So welcome to those that have been listening. How to change your life. You have the power to change your life. And of course, your power will come through areas that you identify with that need to be changed concerning your life, if it's spiritual, physical, mental, or, you know, all across the board. So here we're going to talk about obesity. Obesity in America, I pulled up some stats from the CDC. And according to the CDC, you can go there, just put in obesity, and you'll see that according to their statistics, 1999 to 2000, through 2017 to 2018, there was an increase of obesity from 30.5% to 42.49%. The condition of obesity is related to, or it causes, heart attacks, strokes, type B, diabetes, and certain type of cancer. So this is good information to know. Now, the groups, they put in the groups, and I started with adults because most adults are in the place where they want change, where they can change, you know, habits for their children. So when you change a habit that you came up with and it wasn't healthy, it was negative, then you can change it in your family, okay? So here it says that Black adults were 49% of the statistics of the 30.5 to 42.49. So there's higher. Hispanics, 44.8. Caucasians, 42.4. Asians, 17.4. All right. So the highest percentage in the groups related to obesity, the age range was 20 to 39 years old. So there's where we see that America is saying that there is some work to be done for those that are 20 to 39 years old. Children, 2 to 19 were 18%, averaging in the obesity area. But get this, this 2 to 19 years old at 18% averages out to be 13.7 million children and adult, I mean, and adolescents. Now, given the numbers for the different groups, Hispanics 25.8, Blacks 22.0, Caucasians 14.1, and Asians 11.0%. So what we see here is two areas or groups that are challenged more than others. However, the whole is brought together, which is necessary to know. And what is it that causes obesity? And the reason why I brought obesity up is because a lot of people are looking at changing their lives. And those that are listening to these podcasts, it's been four that I've put out in different areas over the weeks. And in relation to yourself, what we find is that there's a reason why children, let's just focus on children, they're overeating. Children are latchkey, or they were before the pandemic. They eat more than they would if parents were home when there is discipline, right? The other thing is that children will overeat when there is neglect, such as abuse and traumatic experiences. When parents are always belittling or berating children, or even peers, or if they're in school and wherever they are in public, if they're being put in a position of being bullied, overeating can become a part of this. And a story came to my mind. It's no particular person, but I had to speak about it when I seen what I saw, because I saw a woman who had grew up and she began to have weight challenges. And the reason why she was having weight challenges is there was someone that told her that she needed to cover her body. Now, earlier in the years, she was very curvy. She was a very shapely young woman, even in her teen years, very beautiful as a child. But what I saw coming into the picture in my mind is because she was subjected to belittling. She was belittled mentally, physically. There was levels of abuse that she took that in to her subconscious mind and began to actually manifest it in her body. Someone is telling you all the time that you need to cover up, but they're not just telling you that you need to cover up. They're also telling you that you ain't nothing, you're not good enough. What's gonna happen is that it's gonna register, especially someone that is looking at this individual for guidance and they trust them. They're the ones that are leading them. And so what happens is that, you know, the thing you begin to see manifestations in the body, that cover up actually becomes the obesity manifesting through the individual. All through life, even as an adult, they may not know that they've actually gained weight or they've been overeating because it was a comfort. The overeating was feeling a void. And you know, it reminds me of the scripture where the Lord is my shepherd, Psalms 23. And the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. I'm not gonna say the whole thing, but I wanna go to where my cup overflows. So people in the conditions of obesity have been eating, overeating, overdoing whatever they might do to fill a void. You know, some of the other podcasts that I did, they talk about the void. The void has to be filled, but the void also has to be discovered. The void also has to be understood that there is a need to address the issues that have been put into that area where people are feeling like they're empty and nothing, but no one else can do it. We could always go back and undo what people said, but we have to have the knowledge that people or I took on an image within myself and I began to manifest what I was told I needed to do about my body because I was beautiful, because I was curvy, because it would draw attention to me. Sometimes, you know, people don't understand the power of words and how those words can be so defining in a person's life that it can change them from who they were meant to be to who they can be. Now, how do you get your power back when obesity has become a part of who you are? You're going to have to work to release the ideas that others have given you, because it's an idea that you allowed to shape within your subconscious, and now you're wearing what they told you to cover up your beauty. I don't think anyone should be ashamed of their beauty, but there's been a time and an era when we have been subjected to that, even by, you know, different leaders, church leaders, all different types of ideas from our parents, you know, coming up. And this is not to make anyone feel bad, but when you look at the numbers of statistics in obesity, it comes from trauma. It comes from molestation. It comes from addictions, alcoholism. And why? Because someone has passed it on, or you could have been the one that actually began with the trait, right? The key is whatever you want out of life, you definitely have to work at it and prove yourself worthy. That means study. If you really want to do this, you know, motivation. You got to change your whole life. You got to change your life from what you grew up in and what you knew from the past. You know, that situation where the young woman was told to cover up. Maybe the person that told her that did not know it would be so impacting that it would cause her to cover up with weight. You understand what I'm saying? So I hope you guys get something out of this and, you know, design your life if you want to make changes where your morning is consistent with your spiritual life, a devotion. If you go to work, work on that. Put an exercise regimen in there. You know, if you need, put another time of prayer in there. Make your life consistent to what you want it to be. And it takes work because you started off with something that others gave you, but now you have the ability to change what others gave you and walk into your power. As you know, Diana Ross, this is her song, the credits go to her. Love taught her who was the boss. Love has to teach us all. And that means that we become familiar with the love within us, the love that we have to fill us up, not the love that others give us. Because someone made you feel bad about yourself is a responsibility that you have to take to unfeel bad. You take your power back. So a lot of children are not in the know of understanding that every word that impacts you, you don't have to accept it. Every word that's spoken to them, they don't have to accept it. I do believe that, you know, adults have a need to learn how to speak better. And for those that are abusive, you know, that are tearing people down and it causes them to cover up, that's another story because that's a therapeutic need. Anyone that belittles and degrades a person, whether whatever place they're in, they need help. Because love teaches you to love others. That's true love. Love. True love teaches you to repent and ask for forgiveness for the things that you do. Love even tells you to become accountable as an adult. Immature people can't understand accountability because they're always right. So they may not agree with the discussion that we're having, but what we're talking about is the pain that people experience and they take into their inner being and it begins to show on their body. Okay? Now, love teaches you. When you interact with your own love, when you find that love is within you, who is the boss? You guys have a wonderful day and remember that your cup overfloweth. Psalms 23. When you're ready to engage with your cup of love, your cup overfloweth in the hardest of situations, in the face of adversity, your cup overfloweth. And you have the power to change you today, tomorrow, and forevermore. Blessings.